What really frustrates you in a car? We're not talking about other people, those other drivers who seem to lack even the most basic of driving skills. And we're not talking about roads that are either poorly maintained or just bad. No, we're talking about features on a car that just make no sense. Absolutely none. Car design has created some incredible pieces of tech over the last few years, from amazing safety systems to traction control so subtle you'll hardly notice it. But sometimes it's created features we wish would just die. And here's a few in quick succession. If you do enjoy this video, please do remember to give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more from Goodwood Road and Racing. Just why? We hate them. Whether we're talking about a fake tip just beyond a real pipe, or those molded surrounds that go nowhere. Fake exhausts are awful. They're also ubiquitous now, on even the most basic looking of cars. The fake tips just feel like they've been over-designed, and the fully fake ones are just filled in with plastic, letting everyone know that you couldn't spring for the top spec car. Hey, car makers, burn them. Sometimes, just sometimes, voice recognition works. Take Polestar's Google systems, which are a bit of a giggle. But most of the time, you'll find yourself politely speaking a comment only to be asked to repeat it, sending you into a horrendous feedback loop that ends in one thing.
Command not understood.
Rage. Speak at your normal pace.
Call V. Newitt.
Nothing. Try saying it slower.
Call Katie.
Nothing. Maybe a different accent.
Jonathan Crawford?
Nope. Then it turns out, shouting your command at the system just results in your mum being called when you wanted to change the sat-nav.
Calling mum on the mobile phone.
It's meant to help you avoid having to look away from the road. It ends up inducing road rage. Worse, somehow, even than voice control. Also, completely pointless. Oh, thanks. I can twist my fingers around in the air to increase the radio volume. Much better than just, I don't know, twisting my fingers on the volume control. How did I ever live before? Oh, and of course they never work. You end up waggling your hand in the air like you're at a rave, only to resort to using the proper controls. Reversing cameras are great. Do not get us wrong. They're also pretty much everywhere these days. You'll find them on almost everything from an S-Class to a Honda Jazz. But some, well, you might as well just not have bothered. And some of the worst criminals for this include things like the Honda NSX, which has a reversing camera with a resolution so low, the signal appears to have been sent to the moon and back for broadcast. Is that a car behind me? Or is it just a stone? I can't tell. You end up resorting to the old-fashioned wing mirrors, which it turns out are in full HD. Just no. R&D is one of the biggest expenses for any car manufacturer. But for some reason, in some cases, all that research has not managed to tell them how big a bottle of water is. We understand the cars that have those handy multiple-sized ones, because sometimes you have an espresso and that would just fall over in a full-sized one. But there's a whole load of cars that have cup holders that seem to hold absolutely nothing, and then door bins that take nothing more. Useless. Sometimes, lane keep assist can be quite useful. If you're a bit tired and need to be somewhere, it could be a small safety blanket. You're not going to use it, but it'll make you feel a bit less like you're about to wander off the road. But then, there's systems that are preset to be on all the time. The ones that seem to just want to chime in when you're in the middle of a lovely B-road blast, pushing you into the middle of the road for no apparent reason. And then, worst offenders of all, the ones where the button is just nowhere to be found, so you have to pull over to scrabble through a series of menus and try and turn it off. Infuriating. You know the phrase, reinventing the wheel? It basically means to create something that replaces a form of technology that is already fully optimised, changing things for change's sake. But some car brands have decided to take the phrase quite literally. posing the question, when is a wheel not a wheel? Take the one in the Aston Martin Vantage, which is square for some reason. Is that a wheel? Or go even further. What about the new Tesla Model S? That has a yoke, but it still does the same thing, so it's not a yoke. Really? Come on. There's no point. The wheel is fine. You're a passenger in a car, cruising down the motorway. You want to stick some music on to help pass the time. So, you connect your phone to the Bluetooth system and wait for it to boot up, and then, boom, computer says no. The system cannot be used when the car is in motion? Brilliant. I guess I'll sit here in silence. Why? Why put fake vents on a modern car? If it doesn't need vents, why spoil those smooth lines you've spent ages designing? It makes absolutely no sense at all. Those are just a few things on modern cars that really wind us up. But what have we missed out? What do you really hate? Let us know in the comments below.